Hello friends, this is Dr. Janardhan Pawar and I welcome you all to my official YouTube channel, Academic Insight. Today also we are here to talk about one more MCQ question related video. First of all, I once again welcome you all to my official YouTube channel, Academic Insight. If you like my video, don't forget to subscribe the channel. And also press the bell icon so that you'll get this kind of videos in days to come. Also go for liking my video. At the same time, share my video with your friends, relatives and colleagues. And don't forget to write your comment in chat box so that we can improve ourselves in days to come. Today we are talking about the MCQ practice questions of TYBCom semester 5. The subject is Advanced Accounting 1, and today the topic which I have covered for these MCQs is Accounting Standards and IFRS. And here I have taken 13 questions for the purpose of practice. I hope you will do this practice at home. I request you all to watch this video till end so that you will get entire information. I'm starting with question number 1. Here is the question number 1. Accounting Standard Board of India was established in the year. In which year this Accounting Standard Board of India is established? So the options are 1970, 1972, 1973, 1977. So out of these four options, we guys have to find out a correct option. And let us see the correct option. And the correct option is 1977. Moving on to the next question, that is Accounting Standard Board was set up by. Who has set up this Accounting Standard Board? The options are ICAI, ICMAI, ICSI, and the last one, none of the above. Now we are going to find out the correct options for this question. And the correct option is ICAI, that is Institute of Chartered Accountants of India. So this particular body has was set up by this particular Accounting Standard Board. Moving on to the question number 3. What is the aim of accounting standard in India? So behind issuing accounting standard, what were the aims? And these are the options. To make financial statements more comparable, to ensure uniformity in accounting policies, to guide judgment of professional accounts, and the last one, all of the above. Let us see all these options and let us see the correct option. And what is the correct option? Here is the correct option. And the correct option is all of the above. All these statements A, B and C are correct. So this is what we guys have to choose, option number D, that is all of the above. Moving on to the question number 4. And here is the question number 4. What is that? As per Indian GAAP, that is GAAP, financial statements are presented at. The options are market value, fair value, cost and none of the above. And the correct option out of these four options is fair value. Moving on to the question number 5. And here is the question number 5. Which one of the following is not consideration in selection of accounting policies? And these are the options. Prudence, substance or form, materiality. And the last one, that is full disclosure. And the correct option is full disclosure is the correct option. Question number 6 is here with us, that is AS7, that is Accounting Standard 7 stands for or relates to or relevant to. And the options are interim financial reporting, intangible assets, number C, financial reporting of interest in joint ventures, and the last one, construction contracts. And the correct option for this question number 6 is construction contracts. Now question number 7, accounting standards are mandatory for what? The options are sole traders, firms, companies and societies. Out of these four options, we guys have to find out one proper and correct option. And the correct option is companies, no doubt at all. Moving on to the question number 8, accounting standard cannot override the statute. The options are means you guys have to tell whether this statement is correct or whether it is true or false. The options are true, false, maybe false, or all of the above. And the correct option is No doubt it is true. Question number 9. Accounting Standard 25 stands for what? And the options are Interim Financial Reporting, Intangible Assets, Financial Reporting of Interest in Joint Ventures, and the last one, all of the above. And here is the correct option. And the correct option is Interim Financial Reporting. Question number 10, that is AS 17 stands for. And the options are Interim Financial Reporting, Intangible Assets, Financial Reporting of Interest in Joint Ventures, and the last one, that is Segment of Reporting. And the correct option for this question number 10 is Segment Reporting. Question number 11, IFRSR, what they are exactly? IFRS means what? International Financial Reporting Standards. What they are exactly? Whether they are principles is the first option. B, rules. C, partially rules and partially principles. And last one, none of the above. And the correct option is principles. Those are the principles, none other than principles. Question number 12, IFRS are based on. IFRS based on which cost they are asking? Option number 1, historical cost. Second option, fair value. Third option, both historical cost and fair value. And the last one, none of the above. And here is the correct option for this question number 12. What is that? Fair value. Question number 13, and this one is the last question for this video. Indian accounting standard are, and the options are rule-based accounting standards, principle-based accounting standards, partially rule-based and partially principle-based accounting standard, and the last one, none of the above. And the correct option for this last question is principle-based accounting standard. I hope you all have understood whatever questions I have taken for this video. If not, please don't forget to call me and ask your queries, or you can write your query in chat box so that I will answer your query. So this is for this first video. If you really like my video, don't forget to subscribe. Also, press the bell icon so that you'll get videos in days to come. Even like my videos. Also, share my videos and don't forget to write your comment so that I can improve myself in days to come. So thank you very much. It's a time to say bye-bye.